Leia here from leiafirstsci.com, and in this video I will show you how to name ethers. An ether is a molecule typically written out as R bound to O bound to R prime, where R simply represents the rest of the molecule or some carbon chain, and R prime can either be the same R group or a different R group. For example, we can have an ether created by connecting two methyl groups to an oxygen, or creating both a methyl and an ethyl group to an oxygen. There are two common ways to name ethers. The IUPAC rules follow the same rules we've been using for naming organic compounds. We start with your longest carbon chain as your parent chain. On the left we have methyl, giving me a first name of meth. Only single bonds gives me a last name of ane. The shorter carbon chain attached to the oxygen becomes an alkoxy substituent, where you simply take the prefix for the carbon number and add the word oxy. In this case, we'll have methoxy. Since carbon 1 is understood, we ignore the number, giving this a final name of methoxymethane. Same thing applies to my second ether. In this case, my longest carbon chain has two carbons, giving me a first name of F. Only single bonds gives me a last name of ane. A one-carbon substituent on the oxygen gives me a 1-methoxy. Once again, carbon 1 is understood and can be ignored for a final name of methoxyethane. The common name for an ether involves naming the two substituents that are attached to the oxygen followed by the word ether. If the two groups are different, you can arrange them in alphabetical order. Looking back at the first one, I have a methyl group on the left, gives me methyl. A methyl group on the right would give me another methyl, but since it's two the same, I'll use dimethyl, followed by the word ether. On the right, we have both a methyl and an ethyl. Arranged in alphabetical order gives me ethyl for the longer chain, methyl for the shorter chain, followed by ether. When the ether is part of a larger molecule, you still follow the same rules for naming organic compounds. In this example, we start by identifying the parent chain and numbering from the side that gives the ether the lowest number. In this case, I number from the left and get a total of 4 carbons for a first name of butte. Having only single bonds gives me a last name of ane. I have a 2-carbon ether substituent coming off of carbon 2 for a prefix of 2-ethoxy. Putting the name together, I get 2-ethoxybutane. If you're given an ether with cyclic substituents, don't let the apparent complexity fool you. We'll start by identifying the parent chain and follow the regular naming. In this case, 6 carbons gives me a first name of hex, single bonds gives me a last name of ane, and the fact that it's a ring gives me a cyclo. Since my oxy substituent is 5 carbons in a ring, I have the prefix cyclopentoxy. The number 1 is understood given that I have nothing else on the molecule, giving me a final name of cyclopentoxycyclohexane. When you have more than one ether on a molecule, you name it the same way, include a number for the carbon holding each ether, and include the word di to show that you have 2. I start by identifying and highlighting my parent chain. I have a total of 5 carbons on a symmetrical molecule, allowing me to number from either direction. 5 carbons gives me a first name of pent, only single bonds gives me a last name of ane. Both ethers have 2 carbons, appearing one on carbon 1, the other on carbon 5, for a prefix of 1,5-diethoxy. This gives me a final name of 1,5-diethoxypentane. When you have an alcohol and ether on the same molecule, the OH group takes priority. In this case, the molecule is numbered so that OH rather than OCH3 gets a lower number, which means I have to number from the right. 4 carbons gives me a first name of butte. Only single bonds gives me a last name of ane. Since the alcohol is higher priority, I have a functional group of 2-ol. The ether is my substituent, giving me 3-methoxy. Pulling 2 in front of the first name means that O will directly follow E, and so I have to drop the letter E for a final name of 3-methoxy-2-butanol. When you have 2 carbons and an oxygen in a ring, This is called an epoxide or oxirane and will come up a lot in organic chemistry reactions. Therefore, in the next video, we'll look at how to name these specifically in detail. Are you struggling with organic chemistry? Are you looking for information to guide you through the course and help you succeed? If so, download my ebook, 10 Secrets to Acing Organic Chemistry, using the link below, or visit leahforsci.com/orgosecrets. That's O-R-G-O secrets. For information regarding online tutoring, visit leahforsci.com/orgotutor. That's O-R-G-O tutor. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and even share it with a friend or two. If you have any questions regarding this video, leave a comment below or contact me through my Facebook page at facebook.com/leahforsci. There will be many related videos posted over the course of the semester, so go ahead and click the subscribe button to ensure that you don't miss out.